Hello there. Today I'm going to give you a quick tutorial on how I transcribe audio these days. First, a quick note of backstory. I first learned how to transcribe audio when I was a paralegal living in San Diego. I learned how to dictate to type up dictation for my boss using an old foot pedal. That was way back in the day. And then later, when I started to do oral history work and life storytelling, I had to figure out how to transcribe audio. I didn't have a foot pedal dictation machine and went in search of tools. That was in 2016. I first started trying to find transcription tools, and I could not believe how hard it was. Like, I thought, surely there is a better way. And I found a bunch of options at the time, but I just am so happy to tell you the last couple of years have been just a step function up in terms of the tools have gotten so much better. Like, I just can't even tell you how much better and how excited I am to show you how easy it is today. We use a couple of different tools. One of them is O-Transcribe for typing. If you have to listen and type, it's a great free tool online that mimics a dictation machine. But today I'm going to show you some of the automatic transcription tools. Actually, one tool I'm going to demonstrate, and then I'll tell you about a couple of others. So the one that I've been using lately is HappyScribe. It is, I got in on a deal early on when they were offering, you can buy time every month. And so I got in on that deal when they were new and small. And so I'm kind of connected. So that's partly why I use it so much. There are other tools. I'm going to quickly share my screen and show you some pricing, and then I will show you how it works. So share screen function. I'm just going to share this here. So HappyScribe, if you are just paying by the minute, they have a free trial, and it is 20 cents per audio minute. It's really fast, and I'll show you how accurate it is in a minute. They do also have a human-made transcription service, and it's what, $2.25 a minute if you want a human to actually do it. But I don't ever pay that anymore because it's so accurate and good with the tools that I use. Another tool that you might consider is Otter. I know a lot of people really like Otter. I think it's probably a little less expensive. Well, especially if you're only doing small files, they have a free plan. So, and they have an $8.33 a month plan where you would pay it out annually. So if you're going to be doing a lot and you like Otter, I've not used it, so I'm only giving you their current rates. I've heard good things about it, but because I'm connected with HappyScribe and I love it so much, I haven't used it. So one of the limitations with the free plan is that the you can only do three files at a time, but there's a 30-minute per file limitation, and you're limited to 600 minutes a month. But if you're doing less than that, you might start with Otter. Or if you know you're going to be doing a lot, you might consider their paid plan. But if you don't want to do a monthly membership or buy that all at once, or if you know that your files will be longer than 30 minutes, I'm loving HappyScribe at 20 cents a minute. And I will show you here how to do it. So this is my actual files. I have 10 hours a month in this account. And these are all the files that I do. So I taught a class this morning and on Zoom, and I'm going to upload a file right now. So I'm going to upload from my desktop, and we see the files that I have saved on my desktop. So the first thing that I do, by the way, when I'm if I do an interview or a class via Zoom, is I download the files to my desktop. You can set up integrations. I haven't bothered to do that. And for the purposes here, just download the files to your desktop. And I always save the file right away with a descriptive name, with the date, and then the a descriptive file name. So I am uploading here. And then I always click the Use My Vocabulary, and then I click Auto Submit once the file is loaded. And so you can see that it's already 85% of the way there. So you can go to My Vocabulary. These are the words that I have typed in. Get a drink here. For My Vocabulary, some of these are for my business. Some of these are when I work with my family's business, my brother's names, company names, etc. my business name, Evalogue.Life. While that is saving, I'm going to show you something. See, you can see that it's running in the background here. I don't know how it'll be done here pretty quick. It doesn't take long at all. So you'll see in real time. Okay, so it's 6% done. When you go to export, this is so cool. You can export in multiple formats. So you can choose your file type, Word, PDF. You can choose to export it like as a Word document or as subtitles. So that's super helpful because you can take the same document. You don't have to do either a transcription or subtitles. If you want to do like a YouTube video, you can export them one at a time. The other thing is that you get the option here of displaying the timestamps or not. So like if I'm exporting a transcript for my students, I keep the timestamps in there because then they can do a search and find out exactly where they want to go in the video. But if I'm exporting a file that I want to use for my own purposes, like if for it's an oral history project, or maybe I want to export a class that I've taught and I want to use it to help me prepare for the next time I teach that class, I don't display the timestamps because it will save a bunch of room in the document and I might not have to print as many pages, et cetera, or have to remove those timestamps. You can also display the speakers' names, which is helpful because if you have more than one person, you can see who's talking. Or if you don't want to, if it's my own video and I'm the only person speaking, I just delete that because it takes up extra space in the document. You can also show the highlights. The highlights are any words that are, it suspects might be misspelled. So you can quickly skim and see what you think might be misspelled. And you can display comments. You can make comments in the document as well. So those are some of the cool options that you have. And now this will only take another couple of minutes, but I'm going to pause the recording here for a moment. Okay, the file is done. It just took about 5 minutes to get that done. One note is that when I'm downloading from Zoom, I do like to upload the audio file instead of the video file because it's just video files are so huge. They take a lot longer to upload. So that's just a tip. If you have the audio separate, it certainly helps. So let's pop on over to do some editing and I will show you how that looks. Okay, so we're back in our dashboard. I'm going to open the file now. So just to put that in perspective as well, that was about a 50-minute class, and it only took about 5 minutes to run. Amazing. I could go on and on about how bad other tools used to be in the past and how good this is, but I won't. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is go in and edit the person's name. So this is Rachel taught the class this morning. So I'm going to edit speaker number one and add Rachel Trotter. Okay, that's done. And then you can skim down. I don't know if anybody else really chimed in. It might have been all Rachel. So yeah, looks like we're good there. So now I will start sort of skimming. I just sort of skim the red notes. Now, if you want to get it perfect, you can pause. If you don't understand something that was said, you could pause. Oh, is that Rhonda? So that, see, it got my name right. But you can listen right in line as well. So you can hit play and it will play. You're not hearing this because I didn't share with audio, but you can play and then you can rewind 5 seconds or move forward. You can change the playback speed to faster or slower. So basically you could make it super fast and you could type along, listen and fix any errors as you go. So that would be, if you want it to be really perfect, that's how you would do that. I mean, so slick to have the audio and the editing feature right here in line. So this right here, I can see it's not Justin talking, just talking like that. Okay, so I'm just skimming. These audio transcripts, I don't feel like I have to have them perfect. They're for members, students. If it's not perfect, I think you forgive me if there's a word here and there. But you can see just how accurate this actually is with no editing whatsoever. Amazing. So skimming. Pat wouldn't need to be capitalized there. Just pat themselves on the back. Uh, but it knows that Pat is a name. So it capitalized it there. So I realize this is kind of tedious. So let's just assume that we got this done. You can request proofreading. That's an extra service. And now I just will click download. And I am going to download this with the timestamps and with the speaker's name, download it in a Microsoft Word format. And it says it can take a couple of minutes, but I find it usually doesn't take that long. Okay, it's already done. Saving here in my file. I'm just drag and dropping this over to my desktop and voila, we are done. That was how easy it was. Okay, actually, I decided I do want to show you how the file actually looks when you open it. So I'm going to share screen one more time and just show you. This is a PDF just because I have a dark background on my Word. But so you open it up, the names are there, the timestamps are there. As I mentioned earlier, you don't have to include the timestamps. You can export and do a spell check here. You can see occasionally there will be capitalizations that don't need to be there, et cetera. So you can either clean that up in HappyScribe or in Word or a Google Doc or however you want to do it. So, okay, that's it. That's how I transcribe audio and subtitles and videos. Okay, over and out.